Previously on Happy Town.
Xavier was a friend of mine from Manchester. He's had some kind of an accident.
When your ma died, I was convinced it was murder.
You Tommy Conroy? This is the hammer that Peggy Haplin used to kill your mother.
Dan Farmer is the one that drugged me.
Dan Farmer? State Police Dan Farmer?
He's a magic man.
What the hell are you doing?
Dave was talking all kinds of crazy about dead birds, an underground pit where the magic man kept his victims in giant cages.
I just saw the magic man.
I always thought it was pretty, that symbol.
You know, my mother designed it a month after Addie disappeared.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, she said it was a simple way of asking, where have all those angels gone? Okay, so I'll pick you up tonight at your place, 10 o'clock. And, then we're off. What is it?
I just don't know if this is the right time to just pick up and leave for California.
Our families are poisoned, Georgia. If we stay here, we'll become infected.
You're right. Okay, 10 o'clock.
Come on! Oh, bam!
As if there wasn't enough reason to leave this town already.
Hey, it's Gazpacho. Hey, look, it's Gazpacho.
Who?
The guy stole your truck.
What? Daniel Farmer.
Hey! Word on the spit is they think they caught the magic man.
No kidding.
Yeah, they got him over at the station. Some state cop, Dan Farmer.
Are you still pals with Bobby Giordano and those freaks?
Oh, yeah. We was up at their place for a pig roast not a month before you got sprung.
Call.
Done. Where are we going?
Sheriff's station.
Appelbaum County Sheriff. I'm sorry, I don't know anything about that, ma'am.
Hold on, you gotta listen to me. Peggy Haplin killed your mother. I can prove it.
Look, lady, we have a lot going on here today, but if we didn't, I'd have a chance to stop and ask you, who are you anyway?
Tommy, I put Dan in a cell. Now, it's just a flesh wound, but we should get him to a hospital.
Well, put him under heavy guard. Then, TC, you and I should head to both the trailers, the hole in the woods, bag and tag every piece of evidence we can.
Henley, did you hear? I helped to apprehend the magic man.
Really?
Me? Can you believe it? Me?
Come on, Mrs. Nettles.
No, I'm
Let me just walk you out. Right this way.
Mr. Graves, any news on your friend from England?
How kind of you to ask, Rose. No, I'm afraid Xavier is in a very bad way and I must go to him.
Oh, dear. Well, safe travels and good luck.
Thank you, Rose.
If there's anything we can do.
Thank you, Rose.
Hello, TC. Your former best friend in the whole wide world.
I mean the one you didn't blow away in the woods, that is.
What do you want, Greggy?
That guy you have.
What are you talking about?
The guy who destroyed this town, turned neighbor against neighbor.
Created fear, terror.
The guy who took Lauren Ward right when I was aiming on getting her back.
We're not even sure it's him, Greggy.
The guy who made me look like a rat bag in front of my brothers. The guy who stole my truck.
Just let us do our job, Greggy.
Can't do it, TC. We're coming to get him.
What?
Right now. We're bringing the Bumble.
And call the night shift in early. Also, who's off duty today?
Resnick, Caratola, Perkins, Duffy, I think McMullen.
All right, see if you can get him to come in.
Hey, TC, check this out.
the hell's that about?
What are we gonna do, TC?
For the magic man.
You're on parole, Greggy. You really want to do this?
That's right. Here I am, 20 days sprung from the soap, willing to risk going back so that justice can be served.
You disperse now, we'll forget this ever happened. You don't, we're arresting all of you.
Listen to him, Greggy.
But we just have so many questions. How'd he do it? You snatch those people up in public.
And why those random seven?
Yeah. My pretty Lauren Ward.
What about Lauren?
And what about those dead flowers? And why did he stop?
We'll find all that out, Greggy.
What do you think we should do, Rootbeer?
I think you should walk away, Aiden.
Fine. Fine, you're right. Not worth going back to the soak over this. Come on, let's go.
Really?
Yeah, let's go.
Holy cow.
You're doing good, Eli.
Let's call Pike Ben PD. Tell them we're not sure what we got. But if they can send extra men out, we'd be grateful. Just in case.
Hello? Yes? Are they quite sure? All right. Thank you. Apparently, Haplin's finest think they have at long last apprehended him. Please fetch my mother's fine china, Levon. And find my grandson and ask him to come around.
I think you guys should go home.
What's happening?
It's gonna be fine. It's a little chaotic right now.
I want to see him, Tommy.
Rachel, please, not now. He's a state policeman. We're holding a state policeman in custody based on pure conjecture. It is all bad right now.
I'm not leaving until I see him.
Emma, see you good?
Great.
Why are you still here?
Why are you being so dismissive of the truth?
Because it's not the truth. My mother died 5 years ago of a stroke.
Yes, she did. Alice Conroy died at work at Weeping Wall.
Exactly.
That's what they want you to think.
Who is they?
You should ask your father.
What does my father have to do with anything?
He has everything to do with it. Everything.
Hey, TC, you better come see Farmer. He's not looking so good.
Just wait in here.
What's going on?
I'll tell you in a sec. Just for now, talk to the girl.
Hello. I didn't know you were home.
I wasn't. Well, I was, but sleeping. Dreaming. So while I was here, technically, I was elsewhere. In a Paris nightclub, doing the cha-cha-cha with Sophia Loren. Or was it Audrey Hepburn? You know, I always get the two of them mixed up.
Really? How's that possible?
They're old-timey, is why. I'm thinking of crashing a party in Normaltown tonight. Going somewhere?
I'm just gonna go out of town for a few days with Lanny and her mom.
You know, Georgie, we can't change what we are.
What do you mean?
Let me give you a piece of fatherly advice.
Why start now, girl?
You can ask a crocodile to the junior prom. You can buy the crocodile a corsage and a pretty dress of blue. You can dance with the crocodile and get it some punch. But there's one thing for certain. When you go to take a piss, you can pretty much guarantee that crocodile will eat the band. As try as she might, she's still a crocodile.
So what's your advice?
Never ask a crocodile to the junior prom.
Which one's your favorite?
I like this one, Little Susie.
Susie, that's my mom's name. Susie. Susan, but Susie.
You're new in town?
Yeah.
You look so familiar.
Maybe we passed on the street or something.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah.
So what did you want to talk to Tommy about?
Oh, just some police business.
Oh.
Oh, let me get that for you. All right, here you go. Little Susie.
What do you say, Emma?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You look like an angel. Is she an angel, Mommy?
I don't know, sweetie.
How's your wing?
This is ridiculous. You know that.
Tell me why.
Do you really think I'm the man you seek?
I don't know. I also don't understand how you were working here back when all that was going on, and yet we never met. And I don't understand what you were doing to George Braven that night at the hospital. She claims you kidnapped her and her friend. But what I do know is that there are men who want to hang you from the rafters. And what I'm trying to get good with is, why in the hell shouldn't I let them?
Because... I want what you want, Tom Conroy, what your father wants. I want to catch the magic man and his repugnant bird, Cicero. I've made it my life's work. That's why this is the peak of irony, Tom. I'm not him, but I'm the best thing you'll have to catching him.
And how's that?
Because he took something from me. Something that I loved. And he rattles the chains I've been hearing for most of my life.
Who are you, man? Tell me who you are.
I'll tell you this, Tom. I am not the magic.
Dan! Root beer! Root beer, get in here! Kelvin, where the hell's that damn ambulance?
Hi, this is Tommy Conroy from Haplin. I think one of my guys called for backup. You can cancel that request. It was a false alarm. We thought we needed you boys, but we got everything under control here. Yeah. Yeah, thanks, man.
Are you guys okay?
We're fine. What's going on?
Greggy Stivaletto lost his mind. Keep your heads down here. I'll come back later.
I used to date him.
What the hell am I staying back, though?
Freaks have us outgunned here, Tommy. We got 10 men with service pistols on duty. These freaks have more firepower than we do.
Hello? Hello?
You see how it is, Tommy?
Are you kidding me, Greggy? No matter how this goes down, it doesn't end well for you.
Give him up. Because I want to ground his veins into the pavement. And when I am done, I will go merrily on my way.
What happened to you, man?
Oh, things changed for me a long time ago, Tom Conn. And I realized I could do it. I could do it, and I could do it without you. Now give him up. Mob rules. Come on, baby doll.
Not yet, pal.
Watch him for me.
What? Where are you going?
Rachel, get down!
Ray, she needs to get down on the floor!
All the horror you caused! All the sorrow!
Tommy!
All the terror! That's not him! You're not him! He's not him! Why can't you be him? Why can't you be him? Why can't you be him?
He's right, Tom. I'm not him. You know it. I know it. But I guess it's like what your father once told me. Back in those days. It's easier to create the monster than it is to tame it.
Hello, Andrew.
Hey, Grandma.
I have something to show you.
Yeah, what's that?
A film. It's called The Blue Door. It's oddly marvelous.
Now? I need to get home.
Now, Andrew, settle in. It's something you should see. Have a tea cake, dear.
Okay, Tommy. So now we're gonna try a little bit of old-school diplomacy.
What's that mean?
That means that we've taken our first hostage.
What do you want to do?
I don't want to negotiate with those three moon calves. Where's Greggy?
In der Zeit, die der Scharlatten benötigt, die er seine Farbe abzudrehen, wirst du wieder zu Hause sein und heraus. Das Geisterhut und Stürmen aus Verschwung und Liebe.
Warum sagen Sie sowas?
Weil es wahr ist. Besessene Worte sich aus Weinbrot und Lippen offenbaren werden.
Und was werden Sie sagen, diese Worte?
Dass die Stadt in Schutt und Asche versinken wird. Dass in der Gebirgsfläche ein Kreis verborgen kann. Dass ein Baby mit dem Schatten ein Schatten verborgen kann.
say they're in.
Why you gotta make things so difficult, Tommy?
Do you have any idea how stupid this is?
Well, he doesn't look so badass now, does he? Uh-uh.
Well, well. It isn't the queen of the underground.
You're an idiot.
What's going on in there?
Lincoln, look!
Back off there, Boris Karloff.
I think not. I think not.
Hey, buddy.
Your brother is a fool. He's either going to die or return to prison along with your other fool brother. I can see to it that neither of these things will happen, but I need you to release Mr. Haplin and disappear from town.
What the hell are you talking about?
I'm talking about not allowing this boneheaded play of yours, this massively tragic error of judgment, from destroying your family forever. I can make it right.
Yeah.
But unless you do what I say, I will see to it that your brothers are doomed to suffer for all time. You three will have to fend for yourselves for the rest of your days like blind chickens looking for a place to crap.
Are you like James Bond or something?
If James Bond had lion-crushing strength and commanded an army of the undead, then yes, I am.
Okay, and you'll see to it that they get out okay.
I give you my word.
All right, let's go.
What? Are you sure?
Let's go!
Difficult to describe and impossible to duplicate.
Where are you going?
I'm going inside.
No, John. I want to go in there too. I want to see him just as you do. But that situation needs to unravel itself. Don't you see, John? This is your time. It's time to shoulder the mantle of leadership. This town needs you. This is an opportunity. It's a responsibility. Go to the people, John. Gather the people here.
Yes, but my wife.
No, there will be time for that later. Now you take control.
Bobby, let's get on out of here.
I'm not gonna let you do this, Greggy. Put your guns down.
And we got our guns aimed at you, just like you got your guns aimed at us.
Put them down.
And I am this close to stringing John Happen up like a Christmas decoration.
I swear, Greggy.
And still, Tommy Conroy thinks that he is holding all the cards. Good to see you still got the same pills you had in high school, TC.
I got my family here. My wife, my daughter, and these are my men, and it's not gonna happen. So put your guns down now.
Good old TC, same dumb jock he always was.
I said put your guns down now!
Tommy, no!
Look at here, everybody! My left hand! She's working again.
And I was just sitting in my bed, eating my pudding, when one of the nurses asked if I'd heard about the trouble at the station. So I figured it was time to get healthy. Toot sweet.
You can't just leave me in here, you know.
You shot me in the ass. I could bleed to death.
Then what are you gonna do, huh? Oh.
Call around for a caterer for that big party I'm gonna throw? Aiden Stivaletto. You always were either the dumbest smart guy alive or the smartest dumb guy. Haven't figured it out yet.
Oh, I got my reasons, Griff.
Oh, yeah? Well, I hope a hankering for a penitentiary Salisbury steak is one of them.
The others are gone. No sign of anyone.
We'll round them all up. Every last one of them.
Now you see, Andrew, why you cannot leave Haplin, and especially not with a girl in overalls whose daddy blacks her eye. No, you have to stay and begin to be the standard bearer for this family.
That was the worst thing I've ever seen.
It's a classic, and it's who you are, Andrew. It's who we all are.
My father was right. You're crazy.
No, what I am is responsible. You should go to your mother. She'll be needing you tonight. Let him go. He needs time.
Where the hell is that damn ambulance?
I don't know. It should be here by now.
Tommy, can you come over here a sec?
I want to see him, John.
John. I want to see him.
John. Now is not the time.
It's not for me, Tommy. It's them. You want to see him, Tommy. You want to know that it's over.
We need that ambulance, John.
Let me see him first.
As you can see, John, I mean, he's in no shape. But, I mean, that's why we need you to let the ambulance through.
My child is gone because of this man. My wife is, well, basically gone. It's funny because, you know, I thought when I finally lay eyes on him, I'd feel fury, you know, disgust, madness.
And what do you feel?
I feel hungry, actually. You know, I haven't eaten all day. Boy, all these years, you know, I imagine the man that took my daughter. Had fangs and blood red eyes and black oil dripping from his mouth. Not this. This nothing dying on your floor.
Which is why we have to get him to a hospital, John. Because if the others are alive, as it seems they might be.
So that every moment wasted is another measured chunk taken out of the hope of finding them, right?
Exactly.
Okay. I'll tell them. I'll tell the people. Bring an ambulance around the back.
What did he mean when he said they might be alive?
We didn't want to upset you, but we found a severed hand.
Whose hand was it?
It's Lauren Ward.
They're alive.
No, we don't know that for sure.
Oh, they could be. All this time, we stopped looking. They're alive.
Just ride with them to the hospital. We'll be by later.
Copy that.
Hey, have you seen that girl that was here earlier?
No, I haven't seen her. What was that about anyway?
Where's my ambulance going?
You hang in there, Dan. Stay with us. Can you hear me? You know, for what it's worth, I never thought you were the magic man. I'm still not clear on why you blew your truck up in my face, but I try not to take these things personally. It's all water under the bridge as far as I'm concerned.
Hello. What do you mean, where am I? I'm in the back of your ambulance. What? Phil's still at the sheriff's station.
He is?
Then who's driving?
Where did you get a gun? Of course, my gun.
Out, now. Officer Rogers, I need your cell phone, please.
Okay, I'm low on minutes, so...
Start walking.
Dan, what are you...
I said, start walking.
Well done.
Thank you.
Emily, what did she want?
Oh, she was kind of kooky. She was talking all kinds of crazy things. I didn't pay much attention.
She had a tattoo on her shoulder.
Yeah?
Of the question mark with the halo.
Really?
I thought she was new in town.
Yeah, I did too. Yeah, I'll see you guys at home, okay?
Okay.
Be careful.
Hey, GC.
That spooky girl
left this for you.
TC, I think we should let the civil letter sit in there and rot for a while.
Right. Have you seen my dad?
Yeah, he just left. He says he's going back to rehab.
Pop.
Hey, son.
Where you going?
Back to the rehab center. My hand is hurting.
Pop.
What is this?
Where did you get that?
Pop, what is this?
Tommy?
Do I need to send this to the lab? Is this my mother's blood on here, huh? My mother? Your wife?
Tommy, tell me where you got it.
My mother was murdered.
Tommy, Haplin is a place.
No, don't you give me that. Don't you start blaming us on Haplin. Or the darkness of some woman named Chloe. Peggy Haplin killed my mother. And you knew? And you lied about it, you?
They were close. They were as close as a lady of the house and her gardener could be. That night they got into that argument. The weeping wall. And Peggy took that hammer. And they called me.
Who knew about this?
No one, just Peggy and her butler, Levon, the one that doesn't talk. Tommy, I'm the sheriff here, and I always did the best I could and rolled like a fence post. I'm just the sheriff, and Alice was just the gardener. And you? You're just the gardener's son. These people are wicked. And I don't mean ordinary wicked. I mean their blood is black. Their souls are hideous, diabolic.
What the hell happened to you?
I can't live with no more regret, Tommy.
You chop off your other damn hand. You hear me? You chop off your other damn hand because I am not just a gardener's son. I'm the sheriff's son. No. No, I'm the son of the man I thought the sheriff was. How could you? After all this time, how could you? And for those people? For them?
It's the way it works, son, in Haplin.
Not anymore.
Tommy, don't do this! Tommy!
Ma, it worked. Just like you said it would. He's gonna take me there. He's gonna take me to the Magic Man. Where are you?
I'm not coming. We're not going.
What are you talking about?
I have to stay. My place is here.
What?
My place is here in Haplin with my family.
Andrew.
I'm sorry, Georgia, but it's just that I can see it now. And hopefully soon, you will too.
Andrew.
Sorry about getting everything all bollocked up, old boy. Certainly didn't count on being captured.
Yes, well, sometimes when you raid the cat house, you're gonna shoot the piano player.
Still not sure how you managed to get me out.
Your legerdemain.
Legerdemain?
Magic, Xavier. Magic.
Well, that's all fine and dandy, but because of my knocking everything galley west, we still aren't any closer to finding out who is Simon, are we?
No, we are not, but she is.
She is.
She is.
After all, Carl.
About what?
You just can't take a crocodile to the junior prom.
Who cares? They make terrible dance partners anyway. Muffin pizzas and watch Private Benjamin. Like we used to.
How about penne above the stars? Or fettuccine on Mars? He said with a funny face. No more pasta in outer space. Then Angie cried with a fork and spoon. I'll always love spaghetti on the moon.
Hello, Daddy. Andy's reading to me.
Look at us, Dad. We're all together again.
Hello, Sheriff.
Need to speak to you. Excuse me, leave on.
Oh, of course, that's fine. Have a seat, Tommy. You want to talk to me about your mother?
That's right.
Alice was such a dear for a very long time. Such a friend to me.
Did you kill my mother, Mrs. Haplin?
I heard about the ruckus down at the station, that they thought you caught the Magic Man. But he wasn't the Magic Man, was he?
Did you kill my mother, Mrs. Haplin?
That is not the question you should be asking yourself, Tommy.
What?
Hello.
What are you doing here, Griff?
Where are you keeping them? You never told me they're still alive, Alice.
You didn't ask.